What is the best social media platform for growing your coaching business? This is what I'm going to talk about in today's video. I know it can be really overwhelming when you're first getting started with growing an online coaching business. We have Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, LinkedIn, Pinterest, YouTube. There's a million options, right? And you're like, oh my gosh, where should I be? What should I focus on? What do I need to learn to really be successful with growing an online coaching business? And so this is what I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about how do you figure out the best fit for you, okay? You're probably like, oh my, so much to learn. So when it comes to picking the best platform to grow your business, I absolutely 100% believe that this is individualized to you. So there is not one magic social media platform where you need to be to grow a successful business. And there's always new ones popping up, right? And I don't think it's always best to jump on the newest platform and that's gonna be the best way to grow your business. What I like to look at when you're trying to figure out like what is the best way for you is a couple of things. And I'm gonna give you a list so that you can check these off and see what's the best fit for you. So you always want to be first clear on the problem that you help people solve and who is your ideal client. So your ideal client, there's really the two pieces. There's the problem that you help someone solve and then who specifically is that person that has that problem, right? So the problem, for example, could be weight loss. The person who has that problem could be a 50-year-old man. It could be a 25-year-old woman. Could be a 60-year-old woman, right? Like all of those clients are different and you're gonna market to them differently. So you wanna know that because that is going to give you an idea of where is that person hanging out. Where a 60-year-old woman is hanging out is most likely or maybe going to be different than where a 25-year-old woman is hanging out or where a 40-year-old man is hanging out, right? Like we wanna know who are those people, and you can get even specific into, you know, like what kind of career they have, how much money are they making, all those different things. Does that make a difference as far as where you can get in front of this person and what's going to be the best method of marketing as far as the platform you are using? Okay. The other thing you want to keep in mind, what are you already using? Like, what are you comfortable using? Do you already have a following somewhere? Do you already have connections? Are you part of groups in certain places? Because if you do, definitely use that. Like, it's something that's already there. It's the path of least resistance. It's, you know, an easy way for you to get started. So if you're already on Facebook and you use it personally, I wouldn't be like, okay, throw Facebook away. Let's learn a whole new platform and not use Facebook unless you absolutely know for sure that your ideal client isn't hanging out on Facebook. But Facebook is the number one used social media app. So most likely your person is on Facebook and also maybe other places, but just to keep that in mind. The other thing is, what are you good at? Like, what type of social media do you enjoy or do you imagine that you would enjoy creating, and where would you enjoy posting, which is also probably where you enjoy consuming content. So if you really like Instagram and you find that you're using Instagram a lot because you like following other people on Instagram and you enjoy, you know, stories or reels or, you know, whatever it is, like that could be a great platform for you because your ideal client is like you, and what you enjoy, your ideal client is probably gonna enjoy as well. And so I would always look at that too. Like, what do you enjoy? What do you find interesting as far as creating content as well? And that can be a great indicator as far as what platform you wanna be using, okay? So once you look at those different pieces, my advice would be to choose one or two platforms and be consistent and really focus on getting good at creating content there and at interacting with people and creating a community there. It's really not about being everywhere. It's much better to pick, like I said, one or two platforms. when you're getting started. If you want to branch into more platforms as you get going and you kind of master those one or two, that's perfectly fine. But you could just choose one and be successful by using one platform. You don't need to be all over the place. And I think that can be more confusing, especially if you're having each platform works a bit differently. So just because you are, you know how to use Facebook really good doesn't necessarily mean that you know how to use YouTube really good. So just for example, like the platforms that I really use are Facebook. I do some on Instagram, and YouTube is probably like one of my biggest platforms. And that has been really good for me as far as being able to get in front of my ideal client and allowing me to use my skills and the things that I enjoy, which is creating videos. and so that's how I picked. Just to like kind of break these down, because these are the ones I'm most familiar with. Of course, there's other things that you can use, like Pinterest and Twitter and TikTok. You know, like there's endless platforms. I don't know that much about those ones, and I don't have to know because I don't need to use those. But just an example, like, so Facebook is really great as far as like, I believe building community and building groups, having a Facebook group, I've really enjoyed it for that. I think Instagram is really great for people who enjoy sharing their day-to-day life, like using stories. If you enjoy doing reels and being kind of cheeky with it and creating those types of videos, like that's a great choice for you as well. I really enjoy YouTube because your content lives there much longer than it does on other social media platforms. And I like posting content less often, but posting like a little bit of a bigger piece of content with a lot of value behind it. And that's just something that has worked really well for me and that I enjoy. I don't use LinkedIn, but if you work with professionals and you have a great following on LinkedIn, I think that that is like a great platform as well. And some of the other platforms can be amazing too. I just don't know that much about them, but just to keep this in mind and just to kind of have these ideas of what, you know, different platforms are good for and what would be a good fit for you. So the other thing to keep in mind is that I definitely believe in quality over quantity when it comes to using any sort of platform to build your business. Once again, people are looking to connect with you. They're looking for you to share your story, your experiences, to teach them, to inspire them. And it is never about the number of followers you have. There's a lot of people who have a lot of followers on social media who are not making any money in their business, whatever their business may be. It's much more about having quality followers of your ideal client, of the people who are looking for what it is you have to offer, which is most important. And so how you build up a followers of people who are actually your ideal client and people who would potentially want to work with you is by sharing your story, by being authentic and really understanding who that ideal client is and speaking to that person specifically. So it's not about just posting as much as you can and trying to get as much interaction, which of course, you know, can be great. But I really believe that the quality content and when you're really speaking and being intentional about who you're speaking to and have great messaging that connects with people, that that's going to make the biggest difference. And the last piece that I want to share with you that I believe is really important is that no matter what platform you are using to market your business and grow your business, you want to make sure that you're also building your email list so that you're getting people from Instagram, Facebook, you know, wherever you're getting in front of people and having those people follow you, you want to get them onto your email list as well, because you don't own any sort of social media platform. You don't own your following there. And so potentially something could happen, like Facebook could shut down, they could shut down your account, Instagram could shut down your account, which does happen to people. Doesn't happen a lot. I haven't had it happen to clients, but it does sometimes happen. And so if you have an email list, you own your email list, it's off of a social media platform. So if anything would ever happen and you lose your account or a social media platform gets shut down or something, you still, all those people, you still can be in contact with them through your email list, okay? So a great way to build your email list is to have some sort of a free offer that you have. I like to call it a freebie, but it's something really valuable that you offer to your ideal client that they want in exchange for their name and their email. And that is how you grow your email list. So a really important piece, no matter where you decide to market, make sure that you're growing your email list, all right? So I want to thank you for joining me in this week's video. I would love for you to share with me in the comments below, which of these did you find most helpful? And after hearing this, which social media platform feels like the best fit for you? Let me know in the comments below. If you want to dive a bit deeper into the steps to boost your confidence as a coach and get your first clients, I have a new training that I created. I will link it below this video. Make sure you go and check it out. If you want more videos just like this, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I make new videos each week. So I want to thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you in next week's video.